Hello. So in this video I want to share my experience that I recently had with ivermectin. The whole purpose of the Pandemic Hacking channel is that we learn all together as quickly as possible how to deal with all these negative consequences that has the pandemic on our lives. And for that reason I'm going to share this experience. Now let's start with a big fat disclaimer. Do not self-medicate. You would be incredibly stupid to take medicines without the advice of a doctor. So go to your doctor. Absolutely do not listen to me. I'm just, you can imagine something. Don't be stupid and use veterinary products. Like, you would be a complete asshole if you would put something like this in your mouth. And it's notoriously difficult to dose because it's a paste, it's not pills. So don't use this. Do not overdose. That would be really ruining it for everybody, because that would make you end up in the newspaper with a bad story about ivermectin, and we don't need those. So this is for entertainment purposes only. You can just laugh about me and that's perfectly fine. So why did I decide to take ivermectin? Well, in the last more than 6 months already, I've been suffering some chronic symptoms that really are not that usual for me. First of all, I had a pretty high heart rate. I was suffering fatigue attacks, not the normal tiredness, but a type of tiredness that could hit me all of a sudden, and I really had to sit down at least, and I would feel my brain going into the sleep mode. Now, I have experience with, going to a party and not sleeping enough and being tired the next day. But this was different. This was really like attacks of tiredness. Now, also in the last months, I've been suffering from insomnia, big problems to sleep, many nights just sleeping 4 or 5 hours if I would wake up because I had to go to the bathroom or my cat jumped on top of me, then I would be unable to get back to sleep. And I've been struggling with feeling bad about myself, about my life, and that's really not normal for me. I'm quite a light-hearted guy normally, and the last winter has been incredibly difficult. So I tried a lot of things to improve my situation. I cut out a lot of things from my diet that I thought that maybe were not good for me. I'm not really a big drinker, but I decided to stop drinking alcohol altogether. I cut out coffee and sugar. I decided that maybe I should increase my exercise. I also thought that maybe one of my reasons for not feeling so well is because I didn't have enough social contact. So I made a conscious effort to meet up with people, or if that wasn't possible, to at least have a phone call every day. I really made an effort to improve my nutrition. I'm not really a bad eater, but you can always improve, you know. So I'm eating much more leafy greens, much more vegetables. I pay much more attention to what I'm cooking. And I sort of forced myself to have a daily schedule, to get up at a certain time, to be active. All of these things. But while I like all these improvements in my life, and I will continue with them, they didn't really solve my symptoms. So I decided to try ivermectin. Now, where I live, the doctor would not give it to me. So I decided to be a dumb fuck and self-medicate. So step number one. You have to check the warnings and the drug interactions of ivermectin. For this, I used the website of WebMD. First of all, it will give you some warnings for people that should not take ivermectin. And you can input the other medicines that maybe you are taking to check if there are interactions. There are not too many, but if I remember correctly, some blood pressure medication and all that. Well, you can use the website of WebMD to check drug interactions. I don't take any other drugs, so that part was easy for me. Then the information about the dosage, I took it from the FLCCC iMask Plus protocol. I recommend that you take a look at their website and take a look at this protocol. It also mentions other stuff like vitamins that I'm also taking. Yeah, that's the source for that information. So if you are lucky and you can get your hands on some pills of ivermectin, these will usually be, for example, 3 milligrams each, and you can use the table and the iMask Plus protocol to calculate the amount of pills that you have to take. If you are stupid and you are using a product like this one, it's a little bit more difficult to dose it because it's a paste. And I've put a link in the description to a video of mine which explains how to dose horse paste for small horses. So today, finally, I decided to take ivermectin. I've been trying a lot of things to improve my situation, and I've seen some small improvements from the things I've done, but not enough. And I decided to make a video diary about it because, the whole purpose of the Pandemic Hacking channel is that we try all together to learn as quickly as possible how to deal with all this thing and share our experiences so we can get out of this situation as quickly as possible and in the best way as possible. So today at lunch I stuffed myself with a big fatty meal and I took the ivermectin after that. I learned from various sources on the internet that normally, if you would take ivermectin against parasites, you will take it on an empty stomach with some water. However, if you take it because you have or suspect you have or you want to prevent COVID, then you take it on a full stomach after eating a fatty meal, because like that it will be absorbed more in the body. Yeah, I have to say I'm not expecting too much from the ivermectin. I don't really know what's wrong with me. But since we are in a pandemic, I have to expect that it might be COVID. So I decided to try this because ivermectin really, it's a very safe drug. I don't know. Let's see what happens. This is day one. Tomorrow I'm gonna take another dose. And after that I'm gonna wait and see if there is any effect. So I'll keep doing this video diary. I don't know if I'm gonna see any results, but let's see. Well, today is day two of my ivermectin experience. I'm still not really seeing any results. I was still sleeping really crappy, wake up after maybe 4.5 hours. And then after I woke up, like I've been experiencing for months already, I was just really unable to get back to sleep. So maybe I gambled wrong and ivermectin is not the solution to my problem. However, the downsides of ivermectin are very low, so I have to try. Today I took my second dose, the second time also with a big fatty meal at lunchtime. In the next couple of days I'm gonna stop taking doses. And now I want to see if it's gonna have some result or not. I don't really know how quickly it's supposed to work, but until now I don't really notice any difference. So we are in day 3 of my ivermectin test, and today I was really surprised. I woke up after a full night of 8 hours of sleep. I can't really remember the last time that I slept that good. I was really surprised because actually I wasn't really expecting any results. Taking the ivermectin was just a gamble because maybe my chronic symptoms of the last 6 months had to do something with an mostly asymptomatic COVID infection. But yeah, I can't be sure. Maybe I'm just a hypochondriac thinking that I had COVID, no? But, yeah, this morning I woke up after 8 hours of sleep. Then, for the first time in a long time, I felt really good during the day. The last couple of months I was pushing myself to do things, and today I really felt that I felt like doing things. Now, this might still be a coincidence, I don't know. Let's see what happens in the coming days. So today I didn't take ivermectin. Yesterday and the day before I took ivermectin, and now I want to wait and see what happens. So, the story of day three. Let's see what happens this night, if I'm gonna sleep good again. So this is day four of my ivermectin video diary. And last night I slept for a couple of hours, then I woke up because I had to go to the bathroom. And that has happened to me a lot in the last months. But then normally after I woke up, I would be unable to get back to sleep. So this night, to my surprise and to my appreciation, I just went to the bathroom, went back to the bed, put my head down on the pillow, and I slept another 6 hours. So in total this night I've slept 10 hours. Then during the day I didn't have any fatigue attacks. I felt really good about myself, about my life, so no trace of depression. And I don't know. I'm starting to hope that the ivermectin is helping me. So this is day five. On day one and two, I took the dose of ivermectin. Then pretty soon I started to notice a big improvement in my sleeping rhythm, an improvement in my state of mind, just feeling really happy, and an improvement in my fatigue symptoms. So today all of this has continued. I'm still sleeping very well, and was it caused by the ivermectin? Well, I have to be saying that in the last months I've been trying everything possible to improve myself, improve my lifestyle, improve my alimentation, improve my exercise, stop smoking, stop drinking. I never drank that much, but anyway, I cut out sugar, I cut out coffee from my life. And nothing really helped. I still kept feeling like I was walking through a meter of water. And more than anything, it was desperation that made me decide to try the ivermectin. But within 2 days of the first dose, I started to notice a big improvement, sleeping much better, feeling good about my life, and just in general, much more energy. Now that, of course, is just my personal experience. I'm an anecdotal case, but I believe it's important to share it because we need to learn all together from each other's experiences and figure out our way to get through this thing. So after 5 days, what's my interim conclusion? Well, my fatigue attacks are gone, my depression is gone, and I'm sleeping normally. I'm actually enjoying, because before I was quite worried to go to the bed because it was a struggle. And now I put my head on my pillow and I sleep like a baby. That's just awesome. Awesome improvement. So yeah, the bottom line of my ivermectin experience report. I'm really happy about the improvement. I think it's really my quality of life has dramatically improved. I'm not recommending anything, but I think this is worth your attention.